ever thought who can be considered as one of the best anime girls with white hair? Me neither. I'm happy that you are so interested, let's start. Nao is a first-year student and also the student council president of Hoshinoumi Academy. She is hardworking, but is also narcissistic. She has the ability to make herself invisible, but this is limited to one person of her choosing at a time. She is a huge fan of the band Zhiend. She hates people who use their power for no good. Also, she destroyed the protagonist, but I'm not gonna say anything else in order to avoid spoilers. Koneko doesn't show any emotion at all, and says harsh things and hits Iseei when he is doing or thinking something perverted. She shows the most concern for her comrades when they are in trouble. Despite her petite size, Koneko boasts a lot of physical strength and endurance, a standard of the rook. She can lift heavy objects and throw them as weapons with little effort. Also, enemy attacks have been known to bounce right off of her, including light-based weapons that would seriously wound or kill a regular devil. After her identity as an Ikamata was revealed, it was further revealed that she can use Senjutsu and Yaojutsu, but is not fully proficient in using them as compared to her sister. Koneko has the potential to become an even more powerful user of Senjutsu and Yaojutsu than her older sister. With this said, she is the cute kaideer that this anime really needs to balance all the plot walking around, if you know what I mean. She is also my favorite girl. Euclewood, also called URU for short, is a necromancer who brought the protagonist back to life to be her guardian and has been living with him since. She wears an armor that suppresses her abilities and doesn't talk because her power can make her every word spoken become reality. Instead, she communicates to others by using notepad, which usually pertains to her appetite. Although seemingly emotionless and mute, it is shown that she cares deeply about her friends and other people. She does not like the word death, taken lightly, especially since her powers can instantly take a person's life. The main character often daydreams about her speaking in a cutesy manner. I love how she changes her voice in almost every episode, even if her real voice is the cutest for me. Togame is the shogunate self-titled strategian. She is physically weak but mentally superior, though she is not immune to lapses in judgment and bouts of clumsiness. Though Shichika is in love with her, his lack of interest in her body allows her to be shameless around him, so she can be naked around him without worrying about being taken advantage of. In this way, they have a very comfortable and open relationship. She is the daughter of a fallen feudal lord. Iseei thinks that she wears bright clothing so she doesn't forget herself, and comments on her extremely long, white hair, saying hair doesn't become that way without a reason. She also possesses a special eye. She says Jiafan when she falls, and has a habit of saying Cheerio while hitting Shichika, though it turns out Cheerio is erroneous and is supposed to be Chesto. This greatly troubles her, though in the end, she decides to stick with Cheerio. Apart from having my favorite voice actor ever, she is part of one of the most unexpected things ever happened in an anime for me, of course. And if you did not see Katanagatari yet with its beautiful art style, if you do not like it now, it will grow on you. Don't worry, go ahead and do it. It's quite great indeed, maybe one of the best action adventure ever made. Tenshi is the nickname the SSS gives her based on Yuri's belief that she must be a representative of God. Tenshi is one of the two main female characters of the anime. Her name means angel, though she has stated she isn't one. The main plot of the anime revolves around her rivalry with Yuri, as Tenshi is believed to be the enemy of the afterlife. She never admits her name as Angel. Instead, she calls herself the student council president of the school, who oversees the process of the afterlife. What can I even say about her? I have to avoid spoilers. Let's just say that you will feel quite a bit. Have you found something interesting? Hope so, and I also hope to see you again around the channel with that otaku looking face of yours. See you in the next video.